For us children, he was Easter Bunny. He was Santa Claus. He was everything good that you can imagine in one person.
Following the Second World War, a fractured Germany was occupied by the United States, France, Britain, and Soviet Russia, each with dominion over a separate territory. Berlin was the exception. Deep inside the Soviet Eastern Zone, Berlin, too, was subdivided into four occupied regions. The Soviets, determined to extract heavy reparations from Germany and spread communism, were pitted against the Western Allies, who sought to instill democracy and seed capitalism by rebuilding a devastated Germany. In response to Allied efforts to implement the Truman Doctrine throughout Europe and the introduction of a new sovereign currency in Germany, the USSR blocked all traffic to and from West Berlin on June 24, 1948. The blockade soon rendered West Berliners without food or electricity, but the West resolved to intervene on behalf of the Berliners. Hesitant to start another catastrophic war, the British creatively proposed circumnavigating Soviet road blockades by flying supplies directly into Berlin. The only means of stopping the effort would be to fire upon Allied planes, an act of naked aggression the Allies believed the Soviets were unwilling to take.
We never knew whether they were going to shoot at us or wave at us. But we were there to do the job and did it. And credit Truman and saying, hey, you shoot one of those guys down, you got an atom bomb in your backyard.
Just 2 days later, Operation Vittles began the monumental task of supplying over 2 million war-fatigued West Berliners with basic supplies, such as food, water, and fuel, using only two dilapidated airports, Tempelhof and Gatow. Initially, the Allied effort significantly underperformed, and Berliners were subsisting on meager rations. Nevertheless, the humanitarian effort carried on, spurred by Truman's determination.
The United States has a tremendous responsibility to act according to the measure of our power for the good in the world.
While the airlift ramped up, one U.S. Air Force pilot thought beyond mere subsistence and was able to bring cheer to tired children by dropping candies from the clouds that would gently fall into their waiting hands. Colonel Gail S. Halvorsen was transferred to Germany to perform cargo and transport operations for the Berlin airlift. While filming at Tempelhof, Colonel Halvorsen encountered a group of children looking on from the other side of the airfield's fence. Sympathetic to the children's plight, the colonel gave them his last pieces of Wrigley's double mint gum and promised to return with a cargo plane and a big double handful of candy. He told the kids,
"When I come over your heads the first time to circle the land, I'll wiggle the wings of the airplane. When you see the airplane wings wiggle, you know that's Uncle Wiggly wings."
Without seeking permission for his planned airdrop, Colonel Halvorsen purchased as much chocolate and gum with his own ration cards as he could afford. His original intention was to perform the candy drop only once, but upon seeing the elated children, he decided to make the candy drops an integral part of his regular supply runs. Word of the candy drops quickly began to spread, and each week the spectacle attracted ever larger groups of children. Since falling candy dropped at flight altitude could reach speeds of up to 110 miles per hour, Colonel Halvorsen suspended the candy from many parachutes made of handkerchiefs to prevent a potential chocolate collision catastrophe. To deliver the candy, he and his crew repurposed escape hatches on the planes.
And so it was an easy way to dump them out. Just go back and cut holes in the cardboard box, chuck them up the escape hatch, and they go out like snowflakes all over the place.
Soon, Colonel Halvorsen's extracurricular efforts garnered the attention of his superiors. On the eve of December 21st, 1948, Colonel Halvorsen was contacted by Lieutenant General William H. Tunner, his commanding officer.
He called me on the phone and said, "Halvorsen, what you been doing?" I said, "Fine like mad, sir." And he said, "What else you been doing?" And then he saw in the German paper, it was a picture of the airplane, parachutes flying out of it. He said, "Why didn't you get permission?" I told him that I told the kids when they stood on a minute of the fence, I'd drop it the next day.
Halvorsen feared a court-martial and an end to his nascent operation. Yet, to his surprise, General Tunner not only commended him for his efforts, but also expanded upon the operation, formally creating what would be known as Operation Little Vittles, which soon became a household name. Other U.S. pilots and citizens alike offered to aid the Little Vittles operation, and soon, enough candies and handkerchiefs were being donated that Colonel Halvorsen was overwhelmed with the generosity. The impact of Colonel Halvorsen's actions resonated throughout Berlin. Children and parents sent letters to the candy bomber, yet another endearing nickname, to show their appreciation and tell the colonel where to drop the candy. Operation Little Vittles represented more than a contrast of policy between the Western Allies and the Soviets. The parachutes of candy cleared the malaise that had accumulated over the isolated city, giving much-needed hope to the Berliners. As one citizen said to Colonel Halvorsen, "When the weather gets so bad that you can't land, don't worry about us. We can get by on a little food. But if we lose our freedom, we may never get it back." Operation Vittles kept the bodies of Berliners fed, but Operation Little Vittles gave hope to their souls when it was needed most. "Without hope, the soul dies," said another Berliner. "I can live on thin rations, but not without hope." Colonel Halvorsen's efforts exemplified the ideal American spirit.
"I'm grateful we were able to persevere with the Brits and the Americans and some of the French and to help those that were being oppressed by the Soviets."
Colonel Halvorsen and his crew began breaking the barriers of mistrust between the former foes. When the Allies were short on mechanics to service overworked planes, former Luftwaffe engineers were hired. Men that had previously been shooting at each other only years earlier were now working side by side. In addition to regular supply drops, Colonel Halvorsen's operation delivered over 20 tons of candy, suspended by 250,000 handkerchief parachutes in just 14 months. For many children, Gail Halvorsen's acts of kindness were a prominent memory throughout their entire lives, reminding them of the freedom they once needed so desperately. Since retiring in 1974, Colonel Halvorsen has made dozens of visits back to Berlin, reconnecting with many of the people who, as children, were lucky enough to receive candy from Uncle Wiggly Wings. Dagmar Stangraus, one of those lucky children, recounts the memory of Halvorsen's selfless actions.
"I met him. And was this a meeting for me you cannot imagine? No one could imagine how I felt meeting this man. We've been friends ever since. I call him on the phone, I write him letters, I send him my Valentine's card to say he is my Valentine, Christmas, you know, whatever we are doing."
In recognition of Colonel Halvorsen's exemplary actions, both the governor and the congressional delegation of Halvorsen's home state of Utah recommended him to receive the highest civilian award in the United States, the Presidential Medal of Freedom. Even today, well into his 90s, Halvorsen occasionally recreates candy drops for the children of Utah.
"Well, I looked down there when I first flew over Berlin and saw the rubble from the war and the kids playing in the schoolyard, and the school was half blown apart. And I thought what they did to the British people at that time. And it blew up their church, it blew up their family. So war's not a good deal for anybody."
In the wake of World War II, Europe teetered on the edge of further destruction as the Berlin blockade stoked tempers and drew political tensions ever closer to their breaking point. Despite this hostility, the Western forces successfully surpassed the barrier and avoided another conflict, helping to alleviate the Berliners of their fear, misery, and anguish. Perhaps no one more than the Berlin candy bomber himself personified the very nature of the airlift by bringing joy and optimism to disillusioned children.
With his doing what he was doing, he just became the ambassador of what America is all about. Started in Berlin. It started in my hometown, Berlin. But Gail S. Halvorsen, who is now a colonel and about 99 years old, going to be 100 this 10th of October, became the ambassador of goodwill.
Colonel Gail Halvorsen really did become Santa Claus in those gray Berlin days, serving as a beacon of hope for the grief-stricken city and reminding the world that there were barriers worth breaking. Barriers that isolated a community from the world. Barriers that prevented international alliances and destroyed hope and freedom. Barriers that were shattered with one man, his crew, and a big double handful of candy.
"Well, it was more than candy. It was what it meant. Pretty incredible."